Indian nationalist leader Gandhi was born on October 2, 1869 in Porbandar, which was then part of the British Empire. Gandhi's father, Karamchand Gandhi, served as a chief minister in Porbandar and their states in western India. His mother, Putli Bai, was a deeply religious woman who fasted regularly. Young Gandhi was a shy, unremarkable student who was so timid that he slept with the lights on even as a teenager. In the ensuing years, the teenager rebelled by smoking, eating meat, and stealing change from household servants. Although Gandhi was interested in becoming a doctor, his father hoped he would also become a government minister and steered him to enter the legal profession. In 1888, 18-year-old Gandhi sailed for London, England to study law. The young Indian struggled with the transition to Western culture. Upon returning to India in 1891, Gandhi learned that his mother had died just weeks earlier. He struggled to gain his footing as a lawyer. In his first courtroom case, a nervous Gandhi blanked when the time came to cross-examine a witness. He immediately fled the courtroom after reimbursing his client for his legal fees.
Gandhi in South Africa. After struggling to find work as a lawyer in India, Gandhi obtained a one-year contract to perform legal services in South Africa. In April 1893, he sailed for Durban in the South African state of Natal. A similar moment occurred on June 7, 1893, during a train trip to Pretoria, South Africa, when a white man objected to Gandhi's presence in the first-class railway compartment, although he had a ticket. Refusing to move to the back of the train, Gandhi was forcibly removed and thrown off the train at a station in Pietermaritzburg. When Gandhi arrived in South Africa, he was quickly appalled by the discrimination and racial segregation faced by Indian immigrants at the hands of white British and Boer authorities. Upon his first appearance in a Durban courtroom, Gandhi was asked to remove his turban. He refused and left the court instead. The Natal Advertiser mocked him in print as an unwelcome visitor. Gandhi's act of civil disobedience awoke in him a determination to devote himself to fighting the deep disease of color prejudice. He worked that night to try, if possible, to root out the disease and suffer hardships in the process. From that night forward, the small, unassuming man would grow into a giant force for civil rights. Gandhi formed the Natal Indian Congress in 1894 to fight discrimination. In 1906, Gandhi organized his first mass civil disobedience campaign, which he called Satyagraha, Truth and Firmness, in reaction to the South African Transvaal government's new restrictions on the rights of Indians, including the refusal to recognize Hindu marriages. After a brief trip to India in late 1896 and early 1897, Gandhi returned to South Africa with his wife and children. Gandhi ran a thriving legal practice there. When Gandhi sailed from South Africa in 1914 to return home, Smuts wrote, "The saint has left our shores. I sincerely hope forever." At the outbreak of World War I, Gandhi spent several months in London. In 1915, Gandhi founded an ashram in Ahmedabad, India that was open to all castes, wearing a simple loincloth and shawl. Gandhi lived an austere life devoted to prayer, fasting, and meditation. He became known as Mahatma, which means great soul.
When Gandhi sailed from South Africa in 1914 to return home, Smuts wrote, "The saint has left our shores. I sincerely hope forever." At the outbreak of World War I, Gandhi spent several months in London. In 1915, Gandhi founded an ashram in Ahmedabad, India, that was open to all castes. Wearing a simple loincloth and shawl, Gandhi lived an austere life devoted to prayer, fasting, and meditation. He became known as Mahatma, which means great soul. Opposition to British rule in India. In 1919, with India still under the firm control of the British, Gandhi had a political reawakening when the newly enacted Rowlatt Act authorized British authorities to imprison people suspected of sedition without trial. In response, Gandhiji called for a Satyagraha campaign of peaceful protest and strikes. Violence broke out instead, which culminated on April 13, 1919 in the massacre of Amritsar. Troops led by British Brigadier General Reginald Dyer fired machine guns into a crowd of unarmed demonstrators and killed nearly 400 people. No longer able to pledge allegiance to the British government, Gandhi returned the medals he earned for his military services in South Africa and opposed Britain's mandatory military draft of Indians to serve in World War I. Gandhi became a leading figure in the Indian Home Rule movement. Calling for mass boycotts, he urged government officials to stop working for the crown, students to stop attending government schools, soldiers to leave their posts and citizens to stop paying taxes and purchasing British goods. Rather than buy British manufactured clothes, he began to use a portable spinning wheel to produce his own cloth. The spinning wheel soon became a symbol of Indian independence and self-reliance. Gandhi assumed that the leadership of the Indian National Congress and advocated a policy of non-violence and non-cooperation to achieve home rule. After British authorities arrested Gandhi in 1922, he pleaded guilty to 3 counts of sedition. Although sentenced to a 6-year imprisonment, Gandhi was released in February 1924 after appendage surgery. He discovered upon his release that relations between Indians, Hindus and Muslims developed during his time in jail. When violence between the two religious groups flared again, Gandhi began a 3-week fast in the autumn of 1924 to urge unity.
Gandhi returned to active politics in 1930 to protest Britain's Salt Acts, which not only prohibited Indians from collecting or selling salt, but imposed a heavy tax that hit the country's poorest particularly hard. Gandhi planned a new Satyagraha campaign, the Salt March, that entailed a 390-kilometer march to the Arabian Sea, where he could collect salt in symbolic defiance to the government monopoly. My ambition is no less than to convert the British people through non-violence and thus make them see the wrong they have done to India, he wrote days before the march to the British Viceroy, Lord Irwin. He is a well-known world personality. He shook off the British imperialism. The British were compelled to quit India. He secured freedom for our country. He was thus a saintly leader. Finally, India won its independence on 15th August 1947. Unfortunately, the great saint was assassinated by Nadra Vinayak Godse on 13th January 1948. The Quit India movement was the most powerful movement launched by Gandhi to end the British rule in India. He gave the famous slogan, "Do or Die," for the freedom of mother country. He followed the principles of non-violence, truth and peace throughout his life. He guided his fellow citizens to struggle for freedom, not by using weapons, but by following ahimsa, peace and truth. He proved that ahimsa is more powerful than the sword. He adopted the principles of Satyagraha in the Indian independence movement.
Thus, Mahatma Gandhi was both a saint and a practical leader of his compatriots. He was a simple, pure, unselfish, and religious person. He did most of his personal jobs of his own. He fought for the freedom of India through non-violent and peaceful methods. He tried hard to raise the distressed sections of the society. He fought against illiteracy. He dreamt of providing mass employment through Charkha and Khadar. He always felt for the poor and untouchable people. He wanted to abolish untouchability from Indian society. The life and teachings of Mahatma Gandhi were so glorious that people around the world still pay homage to him. We'll always remember his in our hearts. October 2nd this year marks the 152nd birth anniversary of India's most beloved and inspiring leader, Mahatma Gandhi. Fondly called Bapu by millions of Indians, Mahatma Gandhi played a significant role in India's independence, was known for his principles of non-violence and truth, and had started implementing them very early in his life. He taught us to be change we wish to see in the world. He taught us that where there is love, there is life. He followed the path of non-violence to make us unite. He is our father of the nation. Let's remember the Mahatma Gandhi who shook the world in a gentle way. Let us pay homage to the great man who taught the world that even the toughest wars can be won with peace and truth. Teacher set a very good example. Today, on the 152nd birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, India pays tribute to the father of the nation and organizes cleanliness drives to promote Swachh Bharat Abhiyan to make people aware about the advantages of cleanliness. Cleanliness is godliness had been the mantra of Mahatma Gandhi's life. Mahatma Gandhi in his lifeline demonstrated, propagated and insisted for individual and community cleanliness. On this day, our teachers has set a very good example for the mantra, cleanliness is godliness.
Opposition to British rule in India. In 1919, with India still under the firm control of the British, Gandhi had a political reawakening when the newly enacted Rowlatt Act authorized British authorities to imprison people suspected of sedition without trial. In response, Gandhiji called for a Satyagraha campaign of peaceful protest and strikes. Violence broke out instead, which culminated on April 13, 1919 in the massacre of Amritsar. Troops led by British Brigadier General Reginald Dyer fired machine guns into a crowd of unarmed demonstrators and killed nearly 400 people. No longer able to pledge allegiance to the British government, Gandhi returned the medals he earned for his military services in South Africa and opposed Britain's mandatory military draft of Indians to serve in World War I. Gandhi became a leading figure in the Indian Home Rule movement. Calling for mass boycotts, he urged government officials to stop working for the crown, students to stop attending government schools, soldiers to leave their posts and citizens to stop paying taxes and purchasing British goods. Rather than buy British manufactured clothes, he began to use a portable spinning wheel to produce his own clothes. The spinning wheel soon became a symbol of Indian independence and self-reliance. Gandhi assumed that the leadership of the Indian National Congress and advocated a policy of non-violence and non-cooperation to achieve home rule. After British authorities arrested Gandhi in 1922, he pleaded guilty to 3 counts of sedition. Although sentenced to a 6-year imprisonment, Gandhi was released in February 1924 after appendicitis surgery. He discovered upon his release that relations between Indians, Hindus and Muslims developed during his time in jail. When violence between the two religious groups flared again, Gandhi began a 3-week fast in the autumn of 1924 to urge unity.
Gandhi returned to active politics in 1930 to protest Britain's Salt Acts, which not only prohibited Indians from collecting or selling salt, but imposed a heavy tax that hit the country's poorest particularly hard. Gandhi planned a new Satyagraha campaign, the Salt March, that entailed a 390-kilometer march to the Arabian Sea, where he could collect salt in symbolic defiance to the government monopoly. "My ambition is no less than to convert the British people through non-violence and thus make them see the wrong they have done to India," he wrote days before the march to the British Viceroy, Lord Irwin. He is a well-known world personality. He shook off the British imperialism. The British were compelled to quit India. He secured freedom for our country. He was thus a saintly leader. Finally, India won its independence on 15th August 1947. Unfortunately, the great saint was assassinated by Nadra Vinayak Godse on 13 January 1948. The Quit India movement was the most powerful movement launched by Gandhi to end the British rule in India. He gave the famous slogan, "Do or Die," for the freedom of mother country. He followed the principles of non-violence, truth, and peace throughout his life. He guided his fellow citizens to struggle for freedom, not by using weapons, but by following ahimsa, peace, and truth. He proved that ahimsa is more powerful than the sword. He adopted the principles of Satyagraha in the Indian independence movement.
Thus, Mahatma Gandhi was both a saint and a practical leader of his compatriots. He was a simple, pure, unselfish, and religious person. He did most of his personal jobs of his own. He fought for the freedom of India through non-violent and peaceful methods. He tried hard to raise the distressed sections of the society. He fought against illiteracy. He dreamt of providing mass employment through charkha and khadi. He always felt for the poor and untouchable people. He wanted to abolish untouchability from Indian society. The life and teachings of Mahatma Gandhi were so glorious that people around the world still pay homage to him. We'll always remember his in our hearts. October 2nd this year marks the 152nd birth anniversary of India's most beloved and inspiring leader, Mahatma Gandhi. Fondly called Bapu by millions of Indians, Mahatma Gandhi played a significant role in India's independence, was known for his principles of non-violence and truth, and had started implementing them very early in his life. He taught us to be change we wish to see in the world. He taught us that where there is love, there is life. He followed the path of non-violence to make us unite. He is our father of the nation. Let's remember the Mahatma Gandhi who shook the world in a gentle way. Let us pay homage to the great man who taught the world that even the toughest wars can be won with peace and truth. Teachers set a very good example. Today, on the 152nd birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, India pays tribute to the father of the nation and organizes cleanliness drives to promote Swachh Bharat Abhiyan to make people aware about the advantages of cleanliness. "Cleanliness is godliness" had been the mantra of Mahatma Gandhi's life. Mahatma Gandhi in his lifeline demonstrated, propagated and insisted for individual and community cleanliness. On this day, our teachers has set a very good example for the mantra, "Cleanliness is godliness."
Gathered to celebrate the birthday of Mahatma Gandhi. In India, Gandhi Jayanti is celebrated on October 2nd every year.
Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, better known as Mahatma Gandhi, was born on 2nd October 1869 in Porbandar in Gujarat into the middle-class Vaishya family. He was the son of Karamchand and Putli Bai. He studied at the elementary school in Porbandar till the age of 7 and later at Rajkot. He was married to Kasturba at the age of 13 while still in high school. He matriculated from Salamdas College in Bhavnagar, Gujarat and went to England in 1888 to study law. Though his mother opposed this trip, but the opposition was overcome by Gandhi's strict vow of not touching women, wine and meat in the foreign land. He passed
in 1893 went to South Africa to fight a lawsuit on behalf of Dada Abdullah and company. It was the first place which changed the course of Gandhi's life and the history of India. While travelling in a first-class rail compartment, Gandhi was thrown out by railway officials just because a white man objected to his presence in the first-class compartment. This and some other such incidents made Gandhi feel that being quiet will not do any good. He stood up for the cause of all Indians residing there who were suffering from humiliation daily. After fighting for the cause of Indian people in South Africa, he returned to India in 1915.
After returning to India permanently, he began his struggle for independence after joining the Indian National Congress. He acquainted with the issues in India, politics and the problems faced by Indian people. Soon he became a prominent leader in the Congress. He attained independence for the country. Gandhi initiated several movements which helped him to attain his goals.
Civil disobedience movement was launched after the observance of Independence Day in 1930. This movement commenced with the infamous Dandi March when Gandhi left the Sabarmati Ashramam at Ahmedabad on the 4th with 78 other members of the ashramam for Dandi on 12th March 1930. After reaching Dandi, Gandhiji broke the short law and it was ended on 6th April 1930. The non-cooperation movement was a political campaign launched on 4th September 1920 by Mahatma Gandhiji to have Indians revoke their cooperation from the British government with the aim of the British to grant self-governance and full independence to India. The Quit India movement was launched by Mahatma Gandhiji on 8 August 1942 during the World War II, asking for an end to the British rule in India. The movement was started in a speech in Bombay where Mahatma Gandhiji asked Indians to do or die. This movement was also known as Bharat Chodo Andolan. This movement was a mass civil disobedience movement that took place in India.
After independence, Gandhi spent much of his time praying, fasting and discussing duties of citizens. In October 1947, at a prayer meeting in Delhi, he dwelt at length on ticketless travel. People think that since they had won freedom, there was no need to buy tickets. The railway certainly belonged to us now, but ticketless traveling has led to a loss of rupees 8 crore. If people start having free rides in trains, it is a kind of violence. Gandhi often said he did like to live to the age of 125, but around 5 p.m. on 30 January 1948, he was assassinated by Nathuram Godse at Birla House in New Delhi. He was 79.
Mahatma Gandhi was an empowering leader not only because he empowered all Indians on a salt march to corrupt the British economic system. Since he was pioneer of Satyagraha, he also inspired all Indians to understand and learn resistance through non-violent civil disobedience. Gandhi was a visionary leader. He felt it was his responsibility to fight for India's rights. Mahatma Gandhi was important because he led India into freedom from the British. Also, he influenced many people and places other than India. He changed history by protesting non-violently and gaining independence for India.
Thank you. Thank you.